All right, here's another example for determining empirical formula. For this, again, just to review, here's our rules that we're going to be using. Again, the empirical formula, we're looking for that simplest whole number ratio. We convert the mass of each element into moles and then divide by the smallest number of moles. That's just a quick statement of those two. And so in this example, though, we're going to see which one of these three applies down here, where we're not going to get whole numbers from that first division step in this example. All right, so let's take a look at this one. It says a compound contains 43.7% phosphorus and 56.3% oxygen by mass. What's the empirical formula here? So again, as before, we're just going to change those percent signs into gram signs. So we're going to have then 43.7 grams of phosphorus and 56.3 grams of oxygen. For that. So again, I just changed those percent signs into gram amounts. Again, we just assume we have 100 grams of material. So we want to convert each of these gram amounts now into moles. So we want the grams of phosphorus to cancel out. We're going to convert that to moles of phosphorus. Relating grams and moles, the gram amount again is going to come from the periodic table. So here's phosphorus right here, 30.9737. We can round that off to 31.0. We're just going to go with three significant figures for now. And so doing that division, that comes out to 1.41 moles of phosphorus. And then we'll do the same thing for our grams of oxygen. We want the grams of oxygen to cancel out. Moles of oxygen is what we'll put in the numerator. Again, one goes there. Back to the periodic table, 16 for the mass of oxygen. Again, right now we're just using those single atoms. We're not going with what oxygen's normally diatomic. All right. And so that's going to come out to 3.52. moles of oxygen. So at this step, again, we don't want to round yet. We got 1.41 moles of phosphorus, 3.52. It's really, you can't round either of those easily. They're not anywhere near close to whole numbers. So to get these close to whole numbers, our next step then, we're going to divide each of these by the smaller of these two. That's the 1.41. So we'll divide there by 1.41. We'll divide here by 1.41. Of course, divided by itself is just 1 there. 3.52 divided by 1.41, that comes out to 2.496, at least on my calculator. That's what I got when I plugged that in. And so again, I'm going to go to three significant figures. That's what I'm using for everything. So that comes out to 2.50. And so when that happens, again, let's bring this back up for just a second. If you get a number followed by a 0.5, then as it says here, multiply everything by 2. Again, the case we've got here is we didn't get whole numbers for each of these. So if number 2 does not give whole numbers, then multiply all the quotients by a multiplier that will get them to be whole numbers. And so when we have essentially half an atom, that's what that 0.5 means, we're going to multiply everything by 2. All right, so again, this was my rounded off value there. So I have to do this to both of them, though. I can't just do it to the 2.5. I have to do it to the 1 also, because we want to maintain that ratio. So 2 times 1 gives me 2 there, and 2.5 times 2 equals 5. So I get 2 phosphorus atoms and 5 oxygen atoms for this. And so that gives me my empirical formula then. It's going to be a P2O5. All right. So again, if that doesn't come out to whole numbers, then you can round that off. Again, the only other things you might see, this is probably the most common one, is where you get a 0.5 in there, like the 2.5 that we had. You may also get either a 0.33 or a 0.66 or something close to that. That's when you got to multiply everything by 3, or really rare is this one here, a 0.25 or a 0.75. Then you can multiply everything by 4 and get whole numbers that way. All right. So most of the time you'll get whole numbers. If not, second most common is the 0.5, and then these other ones are fairly rare for that to happen. All right, so that's just one more example on how to determine empirical formulas.